Morning, everybody, my dear legendary students. Good morning, everyone.
Good morning, sir.
Morning, Vani, Shivani.
Good morning, sir.
Morning, Rajesh.
Good morning.
Good morning, sir.
Good morning, Maha, Shiva, Shivani. Everything. So, good morning, all of you.
Good morning, sir.
Good morning, Gayatri, Santoshi. Okay. Today we are going to discussing about a very important topic, that is Peripatus. Screen visible, ma?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Today we are going to discussing about a very important question that is will asking so many times in the examination. That is general characters and affinities of Peripatus. Okay. So what is general characters? So introduction of the Peripatus. The Peripatus. So Peripatus belongs to, it will be asking now question. Actually, Peripatus is known as, is connecting between the Annelida and Arthropoda. Connecting between the Annelida and Arthropoda. Okay. So it is one of the connecting link between living fossil. Connecting between the Annelida and Arthropoda character. That's why it is so many affinities are there. Not only this, some characters, Echinodermata characters are there. Some characters, the Platylminthes characters are there. So totally, we are going to discussing about that introduction. So Peripatus belongs to class, separate class is there, Onychophora. Onychophora of phylum Arthropoda. Okay. Onychophora of phylum Arthropoda. It is smallest division of Arthropoda. Peripatus are small worm or caterpillar like animal with a soft, dedicated, and flexible body. So, separate, remembering one thing, in olden days, it is considered as a class of belongs to Arthropoda. But nowadays, now, at presently, Onychophora is a major phyla, that means minor phyla, scientist was considered. And this Peripatus are small worm and caterpillar like structure. Okay, a soft dedicated body and flexible body also. And Peripatus has a restricted distribution. So for the first time, this Peripatus was observed and dust areas which are present in, like dung areas which are present in that. Okay, this Peripatus was first discovered by Gilding scientist. Who scientist, ma? Gilding scientist was discovered this Peripatus. It is generally found in neotropical region of the world, including West Indies and America also. The animal lives under the stone, rock bark, that means different the debris of the leaves, lies, so which are in moisture and dark places. It is present in the moist and dark places. It is present. It is not present in dry areas, right? It is nocturnal in habit. So it is not present in active in diurnal light condition. Okay, now so they are not. They are very much active in day and night time. That's why it's nocturnal in habit and becomes active during the night, but lazy in the daytime. Okay. Peripatus prefer to insects, worms, and termites, larvae, pupae, etc. as a food. Okay. Now, this Peripatus, which is to eat like insects, worm, termites, and larvae of pupae, which are eating. Okay. See, looking these are the Peripatus, which are, there's external character. They are looking like a caterpillar-like structure. the body looking like a flexible, that soft, very dedicated, and the body which is having velvet, the velvet body is there. But no, velvet body is there. These velvet body is there, which are living in the rocks and rocks and bark and which are dust areas, right? It was discovered by a Gilding scientist. Okay, now, so right, which is having looking like a antenna is there. It is arthropodic character, and papilla is there. It's arthropodic character and mouth, and looking like a it is a what? Podia. Podias are the small podias are there. It is looking like a what arthropodic character. The body looking like a soft cavernum, a soft body, a lumbriga. That means tubercles are there, looking like a segments are there. So it is a annelidan characters, right? We are seeing in the diagram and external features of this peripatus, right? The body of the animal is dark and gray to brown. The color is dark gray to brown on the dorsal surface and pole on the ventral surface. Sometime it is also red, blue, and green color also. The body, which color is there? This peripatus looking like a dark gray to brown color and dorsal side. And ventral pole in color, sometimes it will be looking like red and blue and green color, right? Okay. The body is elongated. Cylindrically, the body which is elongated or not cylindrically, with divided into head and trunk. Just now, alert is seen diagram. The body, this is the head and this is the total complete part is called head. This is the trunk, this is the head region, right? Okay, the head of the animal is small, a round structure with the anterior acorn, prostomium is present. Okay. The lateral bears a pair of small eyes, antenna. The antenna also present, small eyes are present. So we are seeing antennas are there, small eyes are present, right? Okay. And both antenna are made up of numerous rings. The antenna which are made up of numerous rings like structure arranged in a linear fashion. A pair of oral papillae present behind the antenna. A pair of oral papillae are present behind the antenna. These papillae which are responsible for tasting of the food. It is small, elevated structure with the opening of slime gland. It is a small elevated structure with the opening of small slime glands are there. Okay. The mouth and anus lies at two ends of the body. The former is ventral while the lateral is internal position. The latter is internal in position. The mouth has a circular lip bearing a small papilla in there. Only a pair of mandible is present in the mouth. It has a circular lining, the linear margin, while outer margin bears suckle shaped continuous teeth are there. This dorsal surface of the buccal cavity has a muscular tongue is there, which also bear continuous teeth are there. And tongue is present, mandible is present, okay, in the buccal cavity, on the mandible. So, okay, but the chitinous teeth are also present, right? Which are cutting on the food material, like which are living in the debris of the leaves, then dust material, which are living, right? Okay, the trunk of the animal, so head region is completed. Head region, eyes are present, antenna is present, papilla is present, mouth is present, mandible is present, right? Okay. Mandible is present, so etc. That is a very important thing about this. Okay. And please mute yourself, ma. Please mute yourself, beta. Okay. The trunk of animal is divided into a small segment. Each segment bears a pair of legs are there. Each segment a pair of small pair of legs are there. Okay, some the segments are not distinctly marked externally. It can be counted by the number one of legs. Peripatus has generally how many pairs? 14 to 93 pairs of legs. How many pairs, ma? 14 to 93 pairs of the legs are there. Each leg has. Each leg has a large proximal triangular part of pointer and distal part is there. How many pairs of legs are there, ma? The trunk animal divided into small. Each segment of legs are there. One pair of legs is there. And totally, how many legs are there, ma?
14 to 93.
Santoshi, please mute yourself, ma. Okay, so each segment which is having a pair of legs, totally how many legs are there? 14 to 93 legs are there. So that is a very important thing. The proximal part has a ring of papilla, while the distal part is composed of a pair of claws. There. Proximal part has a ring of papilla, and distal part of the one paired a claw like is there, claw. Okay. Next, a numerous small papillae presents over the body. Numerous small papillae present over the body. They are more on the dorsal. They are more on the dorsal and less on the ventral surface. Each papilla has a fine spines on the free hand. Each papilla has fine spine on the free hand. So that is important. See, we are internal surface of peripatus, antennae is present, antennal nerve is present, oral papilla is present, okay, a slime duct is present in the mouth, and pharynx, esophagus, and slime glands are present, right? Okay, these elementary canal, small intestine is present, and anus is present. Okay, the body which is having in the lateral side segments are there. The segments which are there, the body which is having velvet body is there. Okay, and the digestive glands, the salivary glands also present. Okay, and the elementary canal, lost rectum and anus will be there. And reproductive system, sperm duct, seminal vesicles, which are there. And nervous system also present. These are the internal structure of the peripatus, right? And body wall. What is about body wall? Body wall, it is composed of an outer layer of epidermis. It is composed of an outer layer of epidermis. Inner layer of the body wall is composed of a small, which as outer coat in longitudinal, inner coat is circular muscles. Outer coat is longitudinal, inner coat is circular muscles are there. Muscular layer is followed by a thin layer, coelomic epithelium is there. It is not only form inner lining of the body wall, it is also form outer covering of viscera also there. Inner lining and outer lining also, which is covered by lining is there. So that is very important. Between the outer and inner, that means coelomic epithelium also there, right? Now, coelom. Okay, this what type of coelom we are observed in the peripatus, right? Okay, body cavity of peripatus. What is that, ma? Body cavity of peripatus is a hemocoel. Hemocoel, it is looking like a sagocoelom. Sagocoelom means which is formed from that means mesoderm splitting, right? The body cavity of peripatus is the hemocoel. The actual coelom is restricted to the gonad and nephridia. The hemocoel divided into four longitudinal compartments. So actually actual coelom is restricted into gonads and nephridia. The hemocoel divided into four longitudinal compartments by the formation of a septa are there. Incomplete septa are there. They are central to they are central one, lateral two, and pericardial sinus of coelom is there. Elementary canal, nervous system are located in this central hemocoelomic system, hemocoelomic coelom, and sinus while excretory organs are present. In lateral sinus, the heart lies in the pericardial sinus. Okay. In the central, okay, elementary nervous system is present. Lateral, what is that? Heart and pericardial sinus is present. And sinuses, which is present, the excretory organs are there. Okay. So on this, we are seeing our diagram. The tongue, antenna, oral papillae, mandibles are there. Okay. And mouth is there. And the mandible, pedinous teeth are present. And first leg also there. So these are the looking like a legs are the, maybe the pair of, how many legs are for 14 to 93 pairs of legs are there. And gonopore is present. Anal gland is opening. Okay. And let us go to what is that diasystem. What is the diasystem of these peripatus? It comprises elementary canal, digestive gland. The elementary canal leads to from a mouth into pharynx. Lateral is the small structure and confined head region. It has an X-shaped lumen lined cuticle and is there. Pharynx open into reduced esophagus. Mouth is there. Mouth is open into pharynx. Pharynx open into reduced esophagus is there, right? Now, please mute yourself, ma. Andri. Okay. It is also then walled structure composed of outer muscular, middle epithelium, inner cuticular layer also there, the esophagus. Outer one is muscular, middle one is epithelial, and inner cuticle layer is there, that is esophagus is formed. The esophagus open into longitubular intestine running from anterior to posterior side, anterior side to posterior side end of the trunk. It is composed of peritropic membrane, which is observative nature. The rectum is followed by the intestine. It is a small tubular structure. And digestive gland. The digestive gland is a pair of salivary gland. It is a small tubular present between third and tenth trunk. So the digestive gland is pair of salivary gland is there. It is a small tubular structure present between the third trunk, third to tenth trunk is there. It is open into through a narrow duct is there. Okay. And next one, circulatory system. What is circulatory system? It is open into open type. The heart lies to dorsal surface, gut, the pericardial sinus. It is present in the sinuses. Canal from the first to long segment of trunk, it is composed of small chambers, which depends on the number of body segments. So this peripatus, which are having open type of circulatory system, heart is present on the dorsal surface, but in pericardial sinus, each chamber of heart communicate the flow of flow chamber by small sphincter. Heart is also communicated with pericardial sinus through the ostium. Okay. And respiratory system. What type of respiratory system you are seeing, right? Peripatus respires through trachea. It is, a branching system present in the entire tissue of the animal. Trachea opened outside through the minute segments, nearly 75 stigmata. 75 stigmata are present in each segment. It has smaller, it is a similar dorsal ventral lip, but the mouth, it is a permanent open structure is there. Flow of air is controlled by muscular. Okay, this is the respiratory system and excretory system. The excretion is performed by nephridia survey. Nephridia of annelida pattern. Same water the earlier we discussed annelida. Same pattern, the annelida also, which is there, nephridia survey present. A pair of nephridia lies in the each segment of trunk. It is a nephridia, that is an annelidan character. And each lateral compartment hemocele. Each nephridium has a long tubular excretory duct. Long tubular excretory duct is there. It is a different histology at different level. The duct is coiled, it is core and open into long excretory vesicles there, which is sac-like structure. The vesicle open it outside body through the excretory pore. Located at the base of the leg, each leg, the excretory pore also, which is open into exterior. It has been calculated that peripat has excreted a few drops of urine after 3 to 4 days, right? This is the excretory system of peripatus. And another system, what type of nervous system is there? It is a primitive type of nervous system, a pair of supraesophageal ganglia present head up the region. They are placed close to each other, fused to form a brain animal. Ventral nerve cord is present, posterior aspects. Okay. And both nerve cord is connected by the large number of transverse branches. It shows the bladder-like structure, looking like a, that means looking like a bladder-like structure of the nervous system is present in these peripatus, right? And sensory organs, okay? Only a pair of small eyes are the sensory organs of the animal. It is generally 0.2 to 0.3 millimeter in diameter. Each eye has an outer circular lens, inner called red cells. They lie together. Therefore, the peripatus is unable to perform image. It can be only differentiate between light and dark. So because of it is a natural. The reproductive system. Okay, the sex are separate. Male reproductive organs are composed. Okay, and vasa differentia is present. Okay, spermatophore are formed. Okay, ejaculate duct is present. Okay, so these are the reproductive system which are there. Female reproductive system is the pair of a small ovary is present. They are irregular tubular structure. Okay, and each of it opens into a common sac like that means aspiratium ovarium. That's there. A small oviduct arises from anterior margin. During the copulation, a pair of uterus arises from oviduct. It moves to anterior to anterior from origin to bent shape towards the posterior end. Both of the unite again to form a small vagina. So both the oviducts to be formed vagina, the lateral opened outside, but through the female genital aperture. Actually, fertilization takes place in the oviduct. Embryonic development occurs in the uterus. Okay, the fertilization takes place in the oviduct. The development takes place in the embryonic, that means uterus. Peripatus is oviparous. That means it will be give the it will lay eggs and give the babies. Hence, give birth as a man. As minute young ones are there. These are the afferentes systems are there, and peripatus systems are there. Now, very important thing, afferentes. What type of afferentes we are discussing, right? The peculiar animal has a combination of the both annelida and arthropoda characters before the making of any conclusion regarding system position. Annelida and arthropoda characters are there. What are the annelida characters? What are the annelida characters? The thin, flexible, able cuticle or epidermis is there. A pair of nepidia in each segment, that is annelida character. True head and absent. Muscular sheath of body wall is similar. Simple eye-like polychaeta is present. As a slime gland is present. Appendage is hollow. Cilia present in the reproductive tract. So these are the annelida characters, right? What are the arthropodic characters? Respiratory respiration by trachea is one of the arthropodic character. Excretory organ close type. A jaw with the stripped muscles are there. A salivary glands looking like insects like hemocele is present. Heart with the ostium. And have head appendages modified to form of mouth part. Yes, antennae is present. A mandible is present, right? These are the arthropodic characters. Nature and position of the gonads similar to insects because of they are present in the abdominal position. Leg has a locomotive organ looking like insects. Leg are clawed and brain is large. These are the arthropodic characters. So totally these are the affinities of arthropoda. After the description of the characters, it can be concluded that is conclude that annelida characters prove it convergence towards annelida, but arthropodic characters keeps it more close to arthropoda. Previously, it was regarded that peripatus was a connecting link between the annelida and arthropoda. Okay, present day study proved that transient arthropoda and peripatus have evolved from the same ancestor. Of course, it is formed from same ancestor, but it is a now it is we are studying with it is a minor phyla. The peripatus form a blind offshoot from the main line of arthropodic evolution. So it is also formed from evolution of arthropoda to be formed of, because of the peripatus ancestral archism we are observed arthropoda. Due to certain difference with the tracheal arthropods, they have been kept independent class, okay, that is Onychophora of arthropoda. Nowadays, the scientists also consider as a Padma minor phyla also, okay? So these are the very important thing about, what is it, ma? These are the thing, very important thing, a very important thing of peripatus. Remembering one thing, so the peripatus, what is peripatus? Describe the peripatus structure and definitions of peripatus, right? So what are the peripatus structure? Where it is present? Who discovered the peripatus? Peripatus is one of the important, belongs to Onychophora phyla, Onychophora class, but nowadays is considered as a, what ma? Considered as a, what ma? Minor phyla, right? Or class, separate independent class. The peripatus which are living in the rocks and debris of the leaves and dust particles when there is a dung areas are there, these peripatus are present, right? This peripatus looking like a velvet body like structure is there. This peripatus, which is discovered by Gilding scientist. It was discovered by Vadma, Gilding scientist. It is located in the neotropical region, right? This peripatus, the body which is looking like a soft body, it is unridden characters, okay? The peripatus on the characters which are having a arthropodic characters are there. So the unridden characters, arthropodic characters are there. That's why the soft body is there, right? Segment body is there. And nephridias are there and legs are there. These are the characters of Anida. Okay. Few of the unridden characters, few of the arthropodic characters are there. So that's why this peripatus, which is what is that one? Which is remembering one thing. It is a connecting link between the arthropoda and Anida. Okay. Now, so this is what a very important thing. Okay. So today, this is one of the session. This session tomorrow, the other same session is there. Okay, so all of you come regularly and daily one long question will cover. Okay, tomorrow, diet system of a prawn and next circulatory system of the prawn we'll discussing tomorrow. Don't miss it. Okay, so today the session is completed. Thank you. Any doubt, ma? No doubt. Thank you very much. Thank you very much, Santoshi. Thank you. So this today's session is completed. This is Krishna sir signing out.